So I'm going to go on to some graph examples, because graph, what I've seen is people get super interested on this stuff. So I ran all these. So first off, relations. If I'm going to take a look at this first table, again, I mentioned in and out. So in and out is basically how we're going to do it. So the in parameter is a person, the out parameter is a product, and we have lots of details on what is in an order, which makes sense, right? So person A ordered product Y. Great. So let's take a look at some of the queries that we would do and what the syntax looks like. So who ordered any products? Through an array. Again, you see the little arrow operator? Makes sense, right? You're connecting the order table here. However, let's take it from the perspective of, I'm gonna think people first. So what does that look like? So just looking through just one in order, who's buying the most? So I get to sort by the total price of the orders. It's a pretty common thing. And who ordered which products? Makes sense. So let me actually go in a little bit of a reverse order. So let's see what products were ordered. Again, the arrows are just going the other way. Hopefully this is kind of making sense to you guys. Is it clicking yet? Anyone not clicking? No? All right, great. Again, I can do this the same way. Basically, which products were generating the most money and what people were ordering the products. You can see how this works. So I'm gonna scroll down here, and this is a fun one. So Zayed, who's gonna be talking a little bit about recommendation engines and much more high level, but this is where I think it's kind of fun. Recommendation engines, anyone not know what a recommendation engine is? Anyone go to Amazon and put something in their cart and check out, and then they go, hey, people who bought this also bought that, right? Well, a lot of people spent a lot of time developing custom APIs and all kinds of stuff. And regardless of how well this is done, I express this simple recommendation in a simple one-line query. So it's a one-line query to do the logic of recommend products that were ordered by other people who also ordered the product I just bought. Well, me being literally just a random person I selected. And you'll see there's some products right there. I think that's very powerful. If you can express that type of logic in one statement, it got me excited anyway. All right, so other things that are pretty interesting that people do on databases. We didn't really talk much about this, and I don't want to spend so much time on here, but full text search. For us, full text search can basically be represented as an analyzer and applying an index to a field on a table, in this case, review text, using that analyzer. And the reason why this is powerful, if anyone hasn't seen full text search, and I'm going to skip over these are just definitions. So this is the first query you would normally do in a normal SQL environment. And by normal, I mean just like an old school. It's basically where the string contains the word formal. And we can see someone put the word formal for formal event in here. However, if there's a typo or someone does a plural, it fails because formals is not a word in that string. However, if you apply full text search indexing, you get that even if someone types formals. So very cool, very clever. And quite frankly, now you don't need yet another database to do this. You don't have to move data back and forth. You just apply an index to your data as is. So here I'm actually talking about, and this is a prep for the next thing, but I get to talk a little bit about stuff going on. So we have the ability to call network calls within database. You can imagine the art of the possible here, but the security minded here, don't freak out. It's completely configurable. You can shut this down. So I pulled in our web page as an example of a get. But what I've done here is I have a little offline, a simple API that can do embeddings. All right, so vector database people, hands? Yeah, all right. So I want to explain what a vector embedding is besides me? No? All right. Well, all right. So basically, you can represent text or any kind of data and turn it into a vector using an embedding algorithm, which takes data and kind of turns it into little numbers. And those little numbers are really useful for comparing things that are like to each other. This is also powering a lot of the stuff you see in LLMs. And we'll, by the way, please come to the meetups we're going to start doing in New York, because we can do lots of cool stuff. We'll do rags and all kinds of fun stuff. So this is very simple. So in this case, I create a little function that gets an embedding of a sentence or any string. So if I look here, this is what that sentence becomes. And now I created a field called vector on the review table. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to put these embeddings into that vector table. So if I look here, now all those review texts have vectors. So basically, I've taken the text of the review and I've turned it into a vector for searching. This will be very cool when you see what's going on later. And just to show you at the end, oh, that's just me doing the test there. Okay, what does that mean? Let me run all these guys and I'll walk you through it. So I'm gonna do another recommendation engine for you, but I'm gonna do a little bit different. And again, this is very simplistic, but maybe it'll inspire people to do something cooler than what I've done. So the first is, let me get a person. Honestly, you can call it me, but it's whatever, a random person. What's the review they wrote? So that's the person. That's the last review they wrote. It has some text here. It has a vector associated. Let's just grab the vector from that review. Here's the product that was in that review. And now let me walk you through. Sorry. Go back here for a sec. So this matched review. So basically, if you can follow this logic, this is how you do a vector search. This is a brute force vector search. And I'm trying to find a review that's similar to the review that this person written, but wasn't written by them and was not the same product. Does it kind of make sense? Yeah? All right. And now I have this matched review. And if I were to run this query, it's going to be a little bit different than my original question. I'm getting a lot more results, because now what I'm doing is I'm taking that match review and I'm looking at the people who bought products like I would do based upon that review, to the order of the review and the products, et cetera, versus the query I ran before, which was just based upon a simplistic recommendation engine.